So we were doing discussion of question answer. We were discussing question answers, and we were discussing question number 4. Okay, so let's begin with this question number 4. Why do Prashant and other volunteer resist the plans to set up institution for orphans and widows? What alternative do they consider? So bachche, get ready with your 4th answer. Get ready with your 4th answer. Okay, so Shivansh, you tell me this answer.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, good morning, beta. You tell me 4th answer.
Prashant and other volunteers resisted the plan of the government to set up institutions for orphans and widows, as they left that in such institutions children would grow up without love and widows would suffer from loneliness. Prashant's group believed to resettle the orphans in their own community as an alternative. They planned to create foster families made up of childless widows and children without adult care.
Good. Good. Very well written.
Thank you, ma'am.
Nice. Now, Dhiren, you tell me the same answer.
Yes, ma'am. The super cyclone that hit the state of Orissa had made thousands of women widows and thousands of children as orphans. And the government plan was to set up an institution to put up the widows and orphans in that. But Prashant knew that all of them had already broken to bits. And if they would be put in that institution, the children would grow without love and the widows would suffer from stigma and become lonely. And they believe that there should be formed new families in which there should be widows who have been and widows and the children who have been orphaned, and this would help them to resettle in their own community and make their life better.
Good. Now same answer, Arzu, you tell me. Yes, Arzu, you tell me same answer.
Yes, the people have formed themselves into groups. Prashant acts as their leader. Women of Kalikuda have formed them into teams to look after the orphaned children. Men work to get food and materials for the shelter. Prashant has persuaded women to work in the food for work program. Thus, the people of community helped one another.
Good. Same answer. Pranshi, you tell me. Yes, Pranshi, you tell me same answer. Pranshi, you tell me same answer. Okay, Ridhima, you tell me.
Morning, ma'am. Likh rahi ho abhi.
Huh?
Writing answer.
Laksh Jairath, you tell me. Laksh Jairath, bachche, you tell me this answer. Nitya, you tell me. Nitya, you tell me this answer.
Prashant and other volunteers resisted the government plans, and as they felt that it would not be proper to help the people that were hit by the cyclone, the group of volunteers helped children, helped orphans who would not be able to get love of their parents, and widow who would suffer the loss of their child and life partner. So they decided to make foster families with orphans and widows.
Okay, good. Very nice, very nicely written. See, because what was the mentality of Prashant, that if such kind of institution would be there, so what would be the result? In such kind of institution, what would be the result? Children would be nurtured up. They would be fostered. But they would be nurtured up, they would be fostered without love, without care, and without affection that children want. Okay? So this was the reason. And moreover, widows, they would not be able to do their work. You can say widows would not be able to do their work properly, and they would also suffer from stigma and loneliness. Okay, so that's why this was the reason that Prashant's group considered the alternative of resettling the orphans in their community. Okay, they planned that such kind of arrangement should be made so that children can be fostered by widows, and widows would be busy in nurturing those children. So they both would get love, affection. They both would be busy. Clear? Am I clear with this? Arzu, what happened? Your brother is disturbing you. He is not letting you study. Okay, so now let's move to next question. Next question we have. Yes, Laksh is raising his hand. Okay, Laksh, unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
You want to tell the answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, bachche, tell me.
Ma'am, fifth question.
No, fourth.
Fourth question. Okay. Prashant and other volunteers resisted the plan of the government to set up institutions for orphans and widows, as they felt that in such situations, institutions, children would grow up without love and widow would suffer from loneliness. Prashant's group believed to resettle the orphans in their own community as an alternative. They planned to create foster families made up of childless widows and children without adult care.
You have copied this answer from All in One Guide, isn't it? It is not your creativity.
No, ma'am. Actually, I read from there also. I added some points.
This is not the right way. You should frame your answer in your own wording. Now, let's move to question number 5. Do you think Prashant is a good leader? Do you think young people can get together to help people during natural calamities? See, in this chapter, it is given that when the condition was so bad, okay, so at that situation, Prashant, he as a young boy, he was a boy of 19 years. So he did not lose hope. Earlier, otherwise, there was no hope at all. But he did not lose hope, okay, and he took some of the initiative. And see, because of initiative taken by one boy, the whole of the situation completely improved. Okay, see, he was only one. Okay, but first of all, he made a team. He took help of other elders. He took help of other youngsters. They made a team. And in this way, he did all the works in a systematic way. Okay, because for him, it was not possible to arrange all the things alone. So what was the thing that he arranged? He arranged food. He cleaned that area. Okay, he made its shelter. after that, when at last, when institutions were made to help widow and two children, he resisted that plan and he gave very good other alternative. So whatever the efforts he had made, that was really appreciable, that was really praiseworthy. So you can say that Prashant really played a role of a good leader. So only by becoming a good leader, he helped thousands of people in a right sense. So do you think Prashant is a good leader? Definitely he was a very good leader. Okay, and do you think young people can get together to help people during natural calamities? Yes, it is very much crystal clear. It is a very right example, real example that is given of Odisha when super cyclone hit in that area in Arsama. So how did those young people, they get together and they sorted out some of the matter. You can say they helped the needy people in a very nice way. Okay, so you have to take example of this chapter in detail and you have to give your viewpoints also in this answer. So in this way, you can frame two paragraphs. In one paragraph, you can give your own views and in second paragraph, you can take example of chapter. Okay, so all of you start framing this answer. All of you get ready and there are only 29 participants only. They will be marked present in my class. Others, if they attend other classes, other subjects, I don't consider them present because they have to be present in every class, in every subject. So all subject teachers will be giving me attendance. So the participants who will be present in all the classes will be marked present. Otherwise, they will be marked absent. So today there are 29 participants in English class. Tell your friends it is compulsory to attend all the classes. Those who are not in class, ring them up after the class and tell them to attend all the classes. Okay, you tell me this answer. Yes, Yug.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, ek sec. Yes, Prashant is a good leader. He didn't ponder over his loss and started helping everybody else. A good leader manages to utilize people and resources to bring the fruitful results. The need of the hour was to fulfill physical as well as mental needs of people in crisis. Prashant managed and motivated his village folks to fulfill those needs. In times of natural calamities, if people come together, then it gives them a sense of strength to tide over the crisis, the feeling that everybody is.
Okay. Nicely written, but you can add some more points. You can pick up some examples.
Ma'am, complete nahi hua.
Okay. Otherwise, you have tried well. Okay. Now, Divya, you tell me same answer.
Yes, ma'am. Undoubtedly, Prashant is a good leader. He has all the qualities of the leader that took the initiative to help the others in Assam. He has a special quality of taking initiative. He faces the adverse circumstances courageously. That youth fellow used his power of youth to assist the society during natural disasters. The situation of Asama could not be predicted, but it can be controlled after the cyclone. And Prashant took the initiative to control it.
Okay, good. Good. Well tried. So Renuka, you tell me this answer. After Renuka, Kavarnur, you should be ready with your answer. Yes, Renuka, what have you written? Renuka, unmute yourself and give me answer. Renuka, are you present in class? Renuka, I'm waiting for your answer. Okay, Kavarnur, you tell me. Kavarnur Singh, you tell me this answer. Yes.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, beta.
Fifth question, na?
Which question is going on? You don't know?
Ma'am, fifth question.
Then you should be confident regarding this because I have explained the full answer. Yes.
Yes, sir. Undoubtedly, Prashant is a good leader. He has all qualities of a leader. He has a special quality of talking in iteratives. His version is quite clear. He faces adverse circumstances courageously. He is a source of energy for others and has a great motivational power. I also think that a youth is a great power. This power can be used to assist society during the natural disasters. Whatever job is assigned to the youth in such circumstances, they perform their duty with full spirit.
Good. Very well written. Very nice. Okay, now Jasleen, you tell me same answer. Renuka, now you are ready with your answer or not? Okay, by the time Jasleen, you tell.
Yes, I think that Prashant was a good leader as he was a teenager, but then also he took an initiative to come forward. He was anxious about the well-being of his family. He has a special quality of initiative. He was very courageous, and his this quality of courage and affection for the people also teaches us to stand bold and cool in hard times.
Good. Very good. So now, bachche, you will be doing these five questions in your fair notebook. And afterwards, I'm going to give you some of the extra questions. These questions you have to do also in your fair notebook. So, bachche, write down these extra questions. After doing these five questions in your fair notebook, you have to do these extra questions. So, write down question number one. How did Prashant feel on the rooftop? How did Prashant feel on the rooftop? How long did he stay there? Okay, bachche. So you start working on this question. That how did he spend his time when he was on rooftop? Okay, and for how long, for how many days he had to stay there? So think about this. So make your answer ready and tell me. Kavarnoor has raised his hand. What about others? Out of 26, only one student know the answer. Out of 26.
Excuse me.
Yes, Kavarnoor.
Ma'am, wo answer dekhna tha piche se. Ma'am, the side please, ma'am.
How did Prashant feel on rooftop? How long did he stay there? So, bachche, you write down this question. Renuka. Now, Renuka is back. Renuka, where have you gone? Tell me for taking your breakfast by keeping your class on. Tell me, where were you when I was calling your name? Now unmute yourself and speak. You are raising your hand. Renuka has written, I am not able to mute myself. So now you can try. Okay. Renuka, take screenshot of attendance and send to me. Today there are only 25. Earlier it was 29. Now it is 25. So you take the screenshot and send to me on my WhatsApp number. Okay. So who is going to tell me this answer? Who is going to tell me this answer? I can ask this answer from any of the child. So you should be ready. Okay, Simran, you tell me this answer. Simran. Simran, unmute yourself and tell me this answer. After Simran, Saksham Gupta should be ready. Now Simran has gone somewhere. Saksham Gupta, will you give answer? Ikjot Kaur.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, good morning. Tell me this answer.
Ma'am, abhi nahi aata ye.
You can find out from the literature book. It is given crystal. Find out and tell me.
Okay.
Okay, Divya, you tell me by the time. Simran is also not responding.
Hello.
Okay, Simran is writing. Okay.
Cluster.
Okay, Jasleen, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. As there was a lot of rain, so he felt frozen on the rooftop. He was very anxious about well-being of his family. He was worried about his family, that his family might not have survived. He stayed there for the 2 days until the rain was completely stopped.
Okay. So it means he was there for 2 days. He was anxiously waiting for the well-being of his family. Okay. And he was also there for and at that time continuous rain was going on. Okay. He was so much worried. He was so much anxious. His condition was so bad, but there was no option for him. So that's why he had to stay there. Okay. And because the rain was not stopping, so that's why he was not having any option and he had to stay there continuously for 2 rains in that unstoppable rain. Okay. So now who is going to tell me this answer? Raise your hand. Hurry up. Saksham, your answer should be ready by now. After Ridhima, you will be telling me this answer, Saksham. Okay, Ridhima, you tell me.
Yes, ma'am. Prashant felt frozen due to the continuous rain. He also cried and worried about his family well-being. It's a long time for 2 days for him. And he was stuck as his friend's house when the storm struck in Orissa. Prashant had to spend 2 nights on the open rooftop in the rain due to the flood. He survived by eating the coconuts from a tree that had fallen on the roof.
Good.
And he bravely and by calmness, he survived the 2 days with heavy storm.
Good, good, good. Good. Now, bachche, write down next. Write down next question. Why did Prashant's heart go cold? Go cold when he reached his village. When he reached his village. Why did Prashant's heart go cold when he reached his village? See, he was very much desperate. He was very much worried, anxious for the well-being of his family. He was not having any options. So that's why he had to spend near about 2 days on the roof. Okay. And he was waiting eagerly that when rain would stop and he would pave a way and he would reach his village. So as soon as he reached his village, what was the condition at that time? His heart go cold. His heart go cold. Sorry, his heart went cold when he reached his village. So what was the condition? Why did Prashant's heart go cold when he reached his village? What was the reason behind that? Tell me. What was the reason behind that? See, that scene, it was really drastic because when he reached his village, he was so completely shocked that he was not able to find out his house there. Only roof on the, you can say, upper part of the house was visible. Okay. And he was completely in panic because he was thinking about his family members, that they were alive or not. Okay. And that's why he was so much worried. And because of that, his heart went cold because he was very much worried for his family. So, all of you get ready with this answer. All of you get ready with this answer. Sudiksha. Sudiksha, you tell me the same answer.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, yes. Vachcha, tell me.
Yes. Prashant's heart went cold when he reached his village because he was afraid that he would have lost his family during this disaster and due to the heavy rainfall. He saw only the remains of the roof and a few of his belongings, of their belongings that were caught up and mangled in the branches of the trees, which were visible from the dark water. So he was very worried about that if his family has survived this catastrophe or not.
Good. Very good. Very well written. Nice. Okay, now Aditya, where is, I am not able to find an option, unmute or mute. Aditya, are you able to unmute yourself? You tell me this answer. Or you don't have mic facility, I think so. Nitish, you tell me same answer. Nitish. Aditya, Nitish and Ashmeet. I think the three don't have mic facility. Nitish, you are unmuted now. You tell me this answer. Ikjot.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me this answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Prashant heart went cold when he reached his village because he was afraid that he would have lost his family due to the storm and heavy rainfall.
Only one line answer you will be writing in 9th class. Only one line answer. You would describe the scene when he reached his village. What kind of scene did he see about his house? His house was there or not? What did he see there? And when he saw that scene, what kind of thoughts were occurring in his mind? You would be describing those thoughts. Then you would be telling that after thinking about this thing, his heart went cold. This is not a right answer, bachche. Put efforts on that. Now, bachche, you will be doing these answers in your fair notebook. We will be continuing with the same chapter tomorrow, because tomorrow I will be doing one or two more questions of this chapter. Okay, then we will start one writing skill. Clear? So whatever the work we are doing daily, you do on the same day so that there should not be any kind of pending work. Okay, now I'm going to over your class, and today I will be sending one of message in WhatsApp group. This is related to your oath. You have to take an oath that you would not take drugs. So that after taking that oath, one certificate will be generated. You have to send that certificate in English group. Clear, bachche? So don't make me to lose my temper. This is a work of hardly 2 minutes. I have also did this. So it was a work of 2 minutes only. I will be sending you link again in group. So it's better that you start sending me. Okay?